Also new at 11 tonight, the Florida Department of Education is facing backlash after removing anti-bullying policies and resources geared toward LGBTQ students from its website. Our Haley Harrison is on your side tonight with why the Department of Education is standing behind this decision and why a local LGBTQ advocate is concerned.
When you try to load the Florida Department of Education's anti-bullying policy online, it says the page is not found. According to a department spokesperson, it had received a complaint that some of the external website links on the page were, quote, inappropriate. The spokesperson says in a statement to First Coast News, "We take allegations such as that very seriously. Therefore, in an abundance of caution, we took the page down to review for appropriateness. Information regarding bullying still exists in several parts of our website." The policy director for Jasmine, Jacksonville's LGBTQ youth organization, says not having these policies and resources readily available is problematic for any student, but especially for the lesbian, gay, bisexual students who made up almost one-fifth of Duval County's student population in 2019.
It is a travesty to think that we can remove policies and resources from this very large population simply based on a single complaint.
Dan Merkin says the Youth Risk and Behavior Survey from 2019 shows about one-fourth of LGB students in Duval County report being bullied on school property. One-fourth also reported being electronically bullied.
That's why it's critical that everybody, take an active role in stopping bullying and harassment so they can learn, they can be a full part of their schools, and feel bonded to their communities.
I'm Haley Harrison, First Coast News, on your side.